You can use Cauchy's integral formula to compute function values inside the domain, or conversely, to compute certain integrals using function values in the domain. But now it becomes even better. We have an extended version of Cauchy's integral formula, which allows you to compute all derivatives of a function inside the domain, or conversely, to compute even more integrals in terms of values of the derivative of a function in the domain. So, how does it work? Well, again, C has to be a simple closed contour, taken once in positive direction, and z0 has to be a point inside C. F of z, of course, again, has to be analytic on and inside C. And then our formula reads as follows. The nth derivative at z0 is given by the following formula. You have, instead of a 1 in the Cauchy's integral formula, you have a n factorial divided by 2 pi I. Still integrate f of z dz, but then you have to divide by z minus z0 to the power n plus 1 instead of z minus z0 to the power 1. You see, if you plug in n equals 0, then you get back to Cauchy's integral formula. So how can we apply it? For example, if you want to compute this integral over there, then we see, well, if we take as function e to the power 2z, which is nice and analytic, if we plug in n equals 3 in Cauchy's integral formula and choose z0 equals 0, so use those data, plug them in into Cauchy's integral formula, then you get the third derivative at 0 equals integral long norm z equals 1, and then we have f of z equals e to the power 2z and z0 equals 0, so we divide by z to the power 3 plus 1 by z to the power 4, which is exactly the integral you want to compute. So you can express your integral in terms of the third derivative of f at 0. So your unknown integral equals 2 pi I over 3 factorial equals 6, times the third derivative of z in 0. But f is just e to the power 2z, so differentiating it is easy. First derivative equals 2 times e to the power 2z, and then 4 times, and then 8 times e to the power 2z. Plug in 0 gives you an 8, so you get as your final answer for the integral 8 pi I over 3. So that's how you can use this extended version of Cauchy's integral formula to compute all kinds of integrals. So why does it hold? Well, let's rewrite first a bit. We use first as our integration variable s instead of z. Okay, that's fine, the s is just a dummy variable. And why do we do that? Well, we want to compute the nth derivative at z. So then we replace z0 by z. Okay, that's also fine. So now we've just renamed some of the variables and we still have the generalized version of Cauchy's integral formula. So we can get now the general version by differentiating Cauchy's integral formula, where we just assume that we can interchange differentiation and integration. So this is the kind of sloppy proof. So what happens if you do that? Here you have Cauchy's integral formula, then you differentiate, you get f prime. The only spot where the z is, you are differentiating with respect to z, the only spot where z is over here. So you have s minus z to the power minus 1. If you differentiate that, you get minus s minus z to the power minus 2 times change factor minus 1, which cancels the other minus sign. So you get 1 over 2 pi I, and then integral fs divided by s minus z squared, which is Cauchy's integral formula with n equals 1. And if you continue like this, you can find a generalized version of Cauchy's integral formula, so which is over here. So this is a kind of sloppy way to prove it. We will do the better way, more precise way in another video, but as you will see in the other video, that will be quite a bit more involved. However, remember from this one, the extended version of Cauchy's integral formula and how to use it.